Now I'll be discussing unemployment, a classical model of labor market which relies on supply demand analysis is useful for studying the wage rate and level of employment in economy, and for showing how these variables are linked to output and productivity. We discussed the problem of unemployment several times before, but now we are discussing how we measure the unemployment, right? To estimate the unemployment rate, this we consider three definitions, which is proposed in your book. Employed if the person worked full time or part time during the past week. Then he will consider as an employed person. Unemployed are those persons who didn't work during the past week but looked for working, especially during the past 4 weeks. Not in labor force are those who didn't work during the past week and didn't look for work during the past 4 weeks. Past 4 weeks are important in order to define these equation or these definition. This is the data of Pakistan, which is collected from Pakistan Bureau of Statistics various years. Employment to population ratio by province and age percentage. 15 or above. Youth 15 to 24 years, right? The division is according to the provinces. This is the collective data or complete Pakistan's data, employment to population data. This is the KPK data. This is from Punjab, Sindh, Balochistan from 2017 and 18, right? KPK, you can see the employment to population is growing in KPK, starting from 3.4 and ended up to 40.6. If you look at the same figure, the 15 years and above employment the population is not changed so far. Like it started from 48.5 and it gradually increases, but later after in 2014 and 15 it goes down. In Balochistan you can see it is also decreasing. It is fluctuating, right? But eventually you can see that the figure is not satisfactory. Over, if you consider youth, you can see in KPK that the data is reflecting that the KPK youth employment population is also decreased. In Punjab, 39.2 from 43.7. In Sindh, it is now 36.5 from 40.2. And in Balochistan, 36.1 from 40.2. And now this is an indicator of employed by sector, right? In agriculture, fishing, mining, manufacturing, and different, sectors, you can see the employment ratio of Pakistan. Over here, population labor force, you can see that this table is divided into urban and rural. Again, provinces in population-wise in labor force, you can see that again, provinces, you can urban, the population and the rural population is increasing from 52.5 to 70.4, 105.7 to 131.1 rural areas. Now I'll be discussing why there are unemployed people. If job finding were instantaneous, then all spells of unemployment would be brief and natural rate would be near zero. There are two main reasons, job search and wage rigidity. Frictional unemployment, the labor market is characterized by a great deal of searching by both workers and firms. Unemployed workers search for suitable jobs and firms with vacancy search for suitable workers. Therefore, there's a problem of frictional unemployment, which is caused by the time it takes workers to search for a job. It occurs even when wages are flexible and there are enough jobs to go around. Frictional employment is due to the when workers have different abilities, preferences, job have different skills requirements, geographic mobility of workers, not instantaneous, etc. Structural employment is resulting from the industrial reorganization, typically due to technological change rather than fluctuation in supply or demand. The long-term and chronic unemployment that exists even when the economy is not in recession is called structural unemployment. The natural rate of unemployment, because of the combination of frictional and structural employment and economy, and unemployed rate is never zero, even when the economy is at full employment level. The rate of unemployment that prevail in an economy, output and employment are at the full employment level is called natural rate of unemployment, right? Now the last topic of this chapter is about Okun's law, which relates the output and unemployment. According to the Okun's law, the gap between an economy full employment output and its actual level of output increases by 2% points for each person point the unemployment rate increase. This is the algebraically we can write the Okun's law, where you can see Y falls short for a full employment output by bar as the percentage of expresses the percentage of Y bar, say that the percentage gap between potential and output, potential and actual output equals to 2 times the cyclical unemployment rate, right?